Ferrari is now 50 years old, but is there any sign of middle-age spread? Well, none that I've noticed. Saab is also 50, a milestone it's celebrated with the launch of the new 9-5. Even Cosworth is as ancient as Sergeant Pepper.
Now, I've got the invitations to all their parties here. Look, there's Ferrari. Yeah, we did that one last week. Saab, the invitation very importantly. Now, they'll just have one glass of wine, then they'll all go and commit suicide. Here we start, some dog and duck, few jars. So, Cosworth's 30th. No. What's this? You're called to the invitation to Jaguar's 75th anniversary. 75, that is really old. But does it mean they're infirm?
It all began with Bill Lyons making sidecars. Then there was this, and then they won Le Mans. And then the E-Type came along, and he had one. Then they stopped racing, and he bought one. And him, and all the cars broke down, and then the factory went Marxist, and now they're all better again.
There's been a change in attitude, too. I mean, this is the interior of the most recent XJ6. Cozy, isn't it? But there are one or two problems. The glove box. Stupidly small. This seat doesn't go quite far enough back for my liking. And these switches along here, you can't see them. Now, in the past, if you'd whinged to Jaguar about petty things like that, you'd have been lucky to escape from the encounter with light bruising. Not anymore. This is the interior of the brand new XJ. Now, you'll note the glove box is larger. The seat goes further back. The switches have been moved. It's nice. Even though there's a telephone stereo combo, it has a traditional feel. I'm thinking that if this car smoked, it would have a pipe. But in fact, it has two. Big ones.
From the outside, this car has new costume jewellery, new bumpers, new wheels, and underneath there's now a 5-speed automatic gearbox.
So, that's it then. Everything anybody could have complained about has been fixed. Great.
But the story isn't over yet. No one ever complained about having to turn the lights on when it went dark, but in this new model you don't have to. It happens automatically. No one ever complained about the performance either, but that didn't stop the backroom boys from upping it a bit. Now, what we've got here are some serious sports cars designed to be fast above all else. There's a Mercedes SLK, low, sleek and light, with a supercharger for added zestfulness. There's a Porsche Boxster, a two-seat mid-engined convertible. Ooh, and there's an Aston Martin DB7. Big, big power under that pretty, pretty body.
And lining up to take them all on is this. A four-door saloon, a car that's about as sporty as a pair of Wellingtons. So it's Nike versus Hunter in a mile-long dash for glory.
Before it was time to cry havoc and let slip the dogs of war, I simply had to put my gearbox in sport mode and shut down the air conditioning.
I appear to be driving the Energizer Bunny. Ordinarily, I have no interest in seeing what's going on under the bonnet of a car, but on this occasion, I shall make an exception. Wow. Actually, this isn't an XJ6 at all, as you've probably gathered. They've stopped making the six-cylinder engine now, and the V12. All XJs from now on come with a V8.
And this one goes a little further, because it's supercharged. It's the £50,000 XJR, and it's the fastest four-door saloon I've ever driven. It is bonkers fast. She's taken the places I should never have been. In bald figures, it develops 370 brake horsepower, roughly the same as a Ferrari 355. I really can't stress this enough. If you're not prepared for the towering poke, the XJR will scare you half to death.
It rockets from 0 to 60 in 5 seconds and is only brought to heel by electronic limiters that cut in at 155. Michael Meacher is gonna love it. Complaint is that the old XJR had a rough and readiness that I liked. It was a bit like Brian Ferry, smooth and sophisticated on the outside, but underneath the Armani dinner jacket, it was still a rock star.
This one, though, comes with computer-controlled suspension and the toughness is gone. You can still feel those big tyres scrabbling away, but it's muted. You can't have manual transmission either, and the V8 is much quieter and more refined than the old 4.6-litre.
Now, you probably think that I'm being silly here, that there are bigger fish to fry, that I should be talking about the complete absence of rear legroom, or the tiny, tiny boot. But look, if you made that bigger, you'd lose the styling. And anyway, if you're worried about that sort of thing, you really are getting on. I mean, Jaguar's 75 now, and this runs on Alco Pops. Basically, if you want a lot of space, buy a field.